welcome back. It's here at VODS, it's coverage of the Mad Catz CSGO Invitational. We're about to have ESC Gaming versus N Faculty, and it looked like ESC Gaming had just won the ninth round as we rejoined it. So ESC are going to start in the CT half on Mirage. We're going to get straight into the game, so we're not even going to have time to pick out players to watch. I've already said QK Mantis, but based on the showing that just happened in an RV game, forget that, scratch that. Anyone at ESC we should be made aware of?
Maybe Taz.
Our boy Taz.
Yeah, exactly. And that's thanks to your prediction earlier, actually.
Yeah, good. Well, I'm glad. I'm glad I've been good for something. So N Faculty are really going to need to pick up this win here. They certainly looked all at sea against Na'Vi. So we're going to see what they can do on Mirage. I've seen them play on Mirage a couple of times. They actually do have some good strats for this map. It's going to be interesting to see what ESC can do and neutralize those.
Worth noting is that Neo has a 5-7. It's the first time I've seen it.
Yeah, well, yeah, you were talking about the 5-7 actually earlier. SMN with the entry frag. So they are. And then Disruptor's going to get another one. So all very good as expected so far. SMN's going to get another one, another kill. They're going to take down the big man, Pasha. Cuban's going to answer back. Kirby's going to get taken down. It's going to be a 3v2 situation.
This round has to go into the favor of N Faculty.
Oh, definitely. At this point, you would feel that it's just a matter of getting the bomb down. That's going to be the hard part. Once it is, they should be able to win. You can see QK Mantis is going to get a face full of flash, but does get that bomb down. That flash isn't going to stop him, and now it's all on Cuban and Neo to rotate and to try and get these kills. Asmo leading them a merry dance, but he's going to moonwalk straight into Cuban, who's going to lick the top of his head up with his gun. So it is going to be a 2v2 situation. Cuban kind of spamming away, but he's going to get caught in the crossfire. QK Mantis is going to get the kill. So now it's all on the mighty Neo, and he can't do anything. SMN had a very good round there. Three kills on the pistol round. That's going to hand the pistol to N Faculty.
Yeah, 1-0 to N Faculty, playing the harder half of this map, which of course is this T half. And probably going to go up to 3-0, though it's worth noting that anti-ecos as T on this map can be quite difficult, since there's so many positions for the CTs to, like, they can stack a bomb site really easily with the PT-50s.
Well, I was going to ask you about that when there was a convenient moment, and now we've got some eco rounds coming in. It seems as good a time as any. Do you feel this is a very T-sided map then?
It's a CT-sided map.
Oh, sorry, CT-sided,
yeah,
right,
CT-sided, okay. Map. Yeah, I really think so. Though, since it's a new map, like, if the metagame change, that can change as well. Like, oh, people figured out how to play terrorist, and suddenly people get 10 rounds every half as terrorist.
For me, it's very hard. I actually feel it's one of the most balanced maps in CSGO, because if you do get that bomb planted, the map is so vast, it's very hard for CTs to rotate. It allows the terrorists time to get into advanced positions, shut down rotates before they get really dangerous. And I feel that if you can get the plant, it's one of those maps where it kind of becomes advantageous to be the T. It's a lot harder to be the CT. You've got that big area in mid where rotating across it's very hard if you put a man there. And I don't know, it feels pretty balanced to me, I'd say.
Yeah, I actually think this is the best map since, best of all the new maps since the basic map, so...
It's really weird, actually.
It's C-decided, but it's not that C-decided, as you say. It's possible to take round as T. It's not as on train as it's like the CT has to make a mistake for you to win a round as terrorist. It's way more balanced than train, I would say.
So we've got ESC just doing what they can here, armed with pistols, 2-0 down. N Faculty not really going gung-ho this round. They're just making sure, because as you pointed out, like that, you can get taken down in the blink of an eye if you don't check the right corner or strafe round at the right angle. So Taz is going to get a headshot. He's also going to get a gun. He's going to hide in the house, which is going to allow him to perhaps lock down the plant from there. And while they're rotating through the mid-area ESC, they are going to trade some frags. You can see Taz has dropped right back now with this AK. Just going to try and play for the kill, see if anyone's going to come out into this advanced position here in the kind of T-spawn area. And in the end, that flash is going to do it. Kirby's going to get the kill on Taz. QK Mantis perhaps with a chance to shine in this game. He's going to get two kills. It is the eco rounds out of the way. It is 3-0. We head towards the all-important buy round. And do you know anything in particular about the way ESC Gaming might play this defensively?
Well, all I know is that Taz will hold the A bomb site standing under that under the ladder area. Basically, he's really, really good at that position, and Neo always holds B2. It's the same position as they had in 1.6, and it's a fast push here from Unfaculty.
Yeah, they've gone very fast this time, and they've really been happy to mix the strat. And as you said there, Taz doing absolute work with a great three-man. You said exactly four-man. You called it. You called it. He played right under there in that ladder area, and he just made that look so easy. They ran out of house, and just everywhere they seemed to land, they were in his crosshairs, and just incredible aim, and that's the first round on the board for ESC.
Yeah, absolutely. And one thing to notice about that position is, people might think like everybody has that position has great aim because they take all the frags, but the thing is, you need to have a player in the CT spawn area taking all the, making a distraction for you, like going forward, peeking, and you can just go out forth there and pick up four frags as Taz did there.
So it's actually more about it's a teamwork thing.
Exactly. Yeah. I mean, of course, you have to have good aim as well, but if you're just standing there and you have no teammate, you're just going to get steamrolled. So.
Well, M Faculty have thought, no more fast strats for us. That didn't work out the way we planned. So they are playing this a lot slower. You can see that QK Mantis has actually picked up an AWP, which it's an interesting development because it's not something you see him do often.
They actually have no one at the B-bomb site right now. Neo might go back and peek. No, they have.
Yeah. I don't know if this is like perhaps some sort of anti-strat. They've certainly got some good timing coming in on those nades and flashes, but Asmo has been able to get the first kill. He's took down Pasha, who was just peeking through the window there. And that's going to give them just a bit of leverage, although he did lose a lot of health in the process of doing that. QK Mantis trying to rush out with this AWP, and in the end, yeah, he wasn't going to get it. His crosshair couldn't snap onto Neo fast enough. And Neo's going to get the kill. He's going to make the call that they're coming out. Cuban's going to get one. They've set up a nice crossfire here, Cuban and Neo. Cuban's going to get two kills before he's taken one on Neo. SMN's going to get another. And you can see Maniac. He's a maniac, I presume that means. He's rotated round and got a kill. So Taz, ooh, I thought he was going to make that there, but SMN was on virtually no health. So it's a 1v1 situation. Yeah, he's gone too far. Really read the situation brilliantly there, and he is going to get the... Oh, and the kill as well, which is the icing on the cake. And that's going to be another round on the board for ESC. So it's 3-2.
And of course, for those who don't know, Maniac is Lord B.
Yeah, I was going to say it's Lord. Yeah, it is the other one. It's not some new Polish player they've just drafted in. He's not heard of. But nice to see them switch names around. Keeps it fresh and exciting.
Yeah, I don't know really. I mean, it's better for the fans for them to keep the same nickname, but yeah, it really doesn't matter that much.
Maybe some brackets. I am Lord. So we've got a full eco coming out, and as the way of all the fast ecos seem to go, it's just pretty much over before it begins. Cuban's going to get two, but Disruptor wraps around the side, and he's going to get an M4 now. So what can he do? Not a lot of much, and there's Lord just going to tie it up at 3 apiece, which gives us an opportunity to have a quick look at the frag charts. Cuban way out in front, thanks to that eco rush straight into his crosshairs. He's got 7 kills and 4 deaths, and SMN, he's got 7 kills as well and 5 deaths from the T side. So it's pretty even Stevens at the moment. We're not seeing a lot going on, but certainly the momentum is with ESC Gaming at the moment.
Yeah, absolutely, and it seems like they're going to try that fast A split again, and I don't think it's going to work. Let's see if Taz can
like be able Lord's to get more position there, and that's a very good flash from under the ladder. He's going to blind all the M Faculty guys, and you can see it's Taz again. They really need to avoid him. He's going to get 2 kills before QK Mantis gets the kill onto him. Pasha has gone really fast. It's not often you see a man of his size move this fast. He's pushed around right behind him into the spawn, and Neo's going to get another kill. Pasha's just sneaking up behind him as stealthy as he can, and he's going to get the kill onto QK Mantis to give ESC Gaming the lead for the first time in the game.
Actually, the thing you pointed out in the beginning, the terrorists should have one guy in middle, like, denying the fast backup. Because you can push 2 slope and 2 house and have one guy like going alone in the middle. It's much better than SN Faculty is doing now, having all 5 go there.
Well, I mean, it's just that was the standard thing. Like on the rare occasions the map was played in Source, that was like pretty much how you played it. You would leave an AWPer in mid, typically, if he was still alive, and then anyone who rotated, he would pick off. And if he died, at least he had the call, it was coming, and it gave you that opportunity to get to a much, much more advantageous position based on where you knew you were going to get flanked from. So that was how it was played. I mean, I'm not saying I don't know how viable it is to do that in CSGO, because obviously it is a very different game, and the map certainly feels a lot more balanced. It was very it was very heavily one-sided in Source. So. But while that's been going on, Kirby has managed to get himself in a 1v2 situation with an M4. So this has been a promising eco while we were jabbering away.
And it does have the bomb. I think he should just go for the...
Oh, he's got to make that kill, though. And in the end, his crosshair placement was a bit wild. Taz holds his nerve. That is going to make it 5-3 to ESC Gaming. We're going to get another buy round coming in. Again, I want to ask you just a little bit about tactically how you think these are measuring up right now. I mean, is this pretty much what you expected to see? Are N faculty showing you anything that makes you think they can win this game?
Well, not really. Just playing very standard, those 3-2A splits and standard play from ESC. Just ESC having a lot of tighter gameplay, or team play, I would say. Like, they can have two guys holding A, and they just work so well together, Taz and the Lord, so that they can basically can kill. Yeah, they rack up like 3 to 4 kills by themselves every time they try to push there.
And again, we've seen this before with N faculty, that when they get their strat shut down early, they do struggle to kind of come up with a plan B. Their plan B just seems to be, let's just spread out across the map and hope we can get a kill. Which UK Madness takes up a good position there on Pasha. Pasha always seems to be the guy exploring for ESC. Usually the first to drop, but makes a good call. Taz is going to get that kill. He knows that someone's up there in that house area. He's just having a quick look. He knows the flashbang's coming out. It's okay. He's in a good position. He's going to get the kill onto SMN. Asmo's having the little peek. The peek off against Taz does get the kill, but then Neo is going to mop up the last kill, which is going to make it 6-3 now for ESC Gaming. And N faculty looks like they're going to be on another eco. Oh no, they are deciding to buy, I think. Are they all buying? Yeah, they are all buying.
Yeah, they have lost six in a row, so they have a lot of money.
They should have been okay. They were slow about buying. I mean, was that maybe... Were they having a discussion about the tactics rather than the weapons?
Maybe they had of the weapons, but this seems like they have grenades. So maybe they had like 4K, 3-8, so yeah. They were like, oh, maybe we should do one eco and have a full buy 2 rounds in a row. But they decided to buy.
It's always a good idea to have the eco while you're kind of at the halfway house, because then obviously it allows you to kind of restock. You're never going to need a double eco at that point. And are they going for this big rush here? Well, that's great play from QK Manix with that double kill. You can see as well, Pash is going to be wrapping around like he likes to do. Just going to be tapping away. But this is a very promising round for M faculty. It is a 3v3 situation. The bomb's ticking away. QK Manix really opened up that bomb site. And he's done some damage. Is this Nate going to find its target? It doesn't. So last man standing is Asmo. What's he going to be able to do?
Oh, he's going to go down for sure.
Yeah, it's not looking very good. I mean, they're just... Well, I don't see how he can stop.
They're missing so much.
I know. This is pretty much awful. I mean, this is like... Either way, if he did clutch it, it would have been one of the worst clutches I'd ever seen. But yeah. Asmo does get a headshot, and then Taz responds back pretty much as we expected to make it 7-3. And that is, you're absolutely right, yeah. 7 rounds in a row for ESC Gaming now. I just feel this is pretty much like what happened with Na'Vi, just without the 3-hour gap.
Yeah, exactly. And faculty trying, in my opinion, the worst tactic that exists in CS, which is the B split on Mirage. I actually never seen a team win it.
Why is it so bad?
I actually don't know. It's like, you can be shot from so many angles when you go what we call the catwalk area, where SMN is right now, where he died. So basically, if you're splitting, you have to have at least two guys going B. So you have only three guys going the catwalk, and you just get demolished as N faculty got last round.
Well, they managed to get a plant again, N faculty. It's a 3v2 situation now, so we'll see if they can hold their nerve and pick up a round. Disruptor with a great little peeking headshot there, so that's going to make it a 3v1 situation, but it is the mighty Taz, and he'll fancy his chances. I don't think he'll be saving his gun. And in the end, that is going to be a round. They've managed to break up that momentum. N faculty are going to take it to 4 rounds as T. What do you consider to be a good number of rounds then? I mean, what's a winnable number of rounds for a terrorist, given that you think it's a CT bias map?
it's very hard to tell since it's such a new map, but I would say if they get like 6 rounds, they have something to work with. So okay. 2 more rounds, and I think they're not okay, but it's doable.
Great AWP pick there from Pasha just while you were talking, and he made it through the blinds there, so he didn't have a lot to work with, only saw a few pixels, but managed to make that AWP work in mid, and that's going to give them a numerical advantage that they're going to certainly enjoy. End faculty now, we're going to have to group up and try and commit to a bomb site. Which one will it be? Because neither of them have really been working out for them. And that's just going to give Lord the license to peek. So that was more of a reconnaissance peek that he did there. Just having a little look just to see where they were. It's a trade-off of damage. No one died. And they know now that chances are they're going to be heading towards that A bomb site, barring some sort of crazy rotate. They are going to commit to it. That flash absolutely rinses everyone. But once again, it's Taz in the perfect position to evade it. Manages to get one kill before QK Mantis, who's really been the kind of the guy with the hot hands for End Faculty, manages to take him down. And he's going to get this plant. He's going to move back into this ladder area. So he's just having a little move around. It's another 3v3 situation. ESC have been having the better of these. But End Faculty will be doing what they can to try and change that. He's got a long-range trade-off there. Kirby with a nice little headshot. And Neo just spamming away from the bomb site, so he gets taken down by QK Mantis. Pasha thinks, I'm going to have to probably save this AWP. He is going to get one kill. Disruptor's like, look, it's okay, boys. He's running. No need to chase. Just get away from the bomb and try and save your guns because we're low HP. Are they going to be able to do that? Yes, they are. And we might get a little bit. Yeah, it's gutted. Absolutely gutted. Pasha in the end not able to make it count. So that's 2 rounds back to back now.
And I think they're forced to an eco. Actually,
yeah, so. Well, again, it's looking that way. They're certainly not. They're not buying. So this should be 3 rounds in a row, and that'll make it 7-6, which is certainly, like you said, yeah. 6 round would give them something to work with. So.
I'm very surprised they're getting so many rounds, actually.
Well, I was going to ask, I mean, have they done anything that you thought maybe is good? I mean, you were talking about how they were playing a standard team earlier. Yeah. Have they changed anything? Are they doing anything special? Is this ESC just flip-flopping?
Well, they're playing a little better. Now they're doing the A-splits, but before they're doing the A-splits, they just try to pick some information, like fake some B before they go A, so they won't get flanked as quickly as they got in previous rounds. So I feel like they're reading ESC pretty well.
Well, for me, QK Mantis is having a great little game. I've had the double jinx there. I called him to be good in the game against Na'Vi. He wasn't. I said, don't watch him this game then, because he's probably not going to have a good LAN, and now he's gone 6. So... you can't do right for doing wrong when you're a commentator, evidently. So, but that is going to make it 7 rounds to 6. And Faculty coming back into this game. ESC Gaming are going to be thinking, I'm not quite sure what's going on here. And certainly at the moment, End Faculty have got the momentum. It's going to be interesting to see what they do. So, yep, they're going to just come straight out of this house again. And it's just going to keep feeding Taz these frags. But in the end, he's only going to get 2 this time before he gets taken out of this round. And all of a sudden, it's a 3v2 situation again for End Faculty. So Kirby just dodging that flash, going into the spray. He's not going to do any damage. You can see Cuban and Neo.
Neo really should have gotten that pick right there. He flashed Kirby completely.
Well, he's done it belatedly with the nade. So if you can't do it with a gun, always have a nade as backup. They're pretty well positioned at the moment. We're going to switch to Cuban, it seems. And Asmo's going to get one and make that 2. So, again, auto director, probably should have switched to him, bro. It's 7-7. End Faculty, I mean, there's a conceivable chance that they can actually win this round.
Yeah, absolutely. Still, I don't really know the metagame for Mirage in CSGO as well as I did in the 1.6. So it might have changed right now to our team map. I don't know. But last time I checked, 7 rounds is a really good score as terrorists.
Well, it looks like it could be 8 because you will have noticed, if you're watching at home, you'll have noticed that what ESC of Gaming have had to do is they've had to buy some Famuses, which of course aren't. A gun, certainly no match for the mighty AK, and End Faculty have just run out onto this B bombsite. They've got the plant. They just literally finding it very easy all of a sudden. And this is what I mean about N-Faculty. As a team, they are just so ridiculously inconsistent. They lurch from the ridiculous to the sublime. They seem to be driven by momentum, by, you know, mood. And it's incredible, really. So it's all on Lord to make this 1v3 situation. He's just going to get naded out of it. And SMN's going to get the last kill. So good half. N-Faculty coming back after losing, after winning the pistol, going 3-0 up. They lose 7 rounds in a row, and then they win the next 5 to win the half 8-7.
A very strange half, and just proves how much momentum has to do with winning rounds in CS. Like, it's so good to string rounds together. And the pistol is going live right away.
Yep, straight into it. No rest for the wicked, I guess.
A decoy grenade.
Yeah, and a decoy. How bizarre.
I think they threw the... He must have bought wrong.
Well, maybe, or maybe it's some sort of super strap, like, which we've never seen. But look at this position from Disruptor. Very keen, very effective. Going to get first blood, take down Taz. That'll be music to his team's ears that Taz is out of the equation. Pasha, though, and Neo are going to have to bat. And Pasha's loving it at the moment with the Glock. Lord's going to get that next kill. And what started out as a promising round for N-Faculty is now very promising indeed for ESC. And they are going to tie it up at 8 rounds apiece. And they should take a 10-8 lead here. So let's talk a little bit about what you know about...
I just have to talk about that decoy grenade. Like,
talk about the decoy grenade.
What the hell was that? Like, the weirdest way to use it as well. Like, you throw a decoy grenade, wait like 5 seconds, and then you rush the same place where you threw the decoy grenade. It's like, it didn't make any sense at all.
Is it perhaps some sort of super double fake?
Yeah, I don't know.
Oh, they've thrown like, the decoy. They're
faking it, the worst decoy of all time. Like,
no, but it
one decoy.
It could be like, because you say it's so stupid.
Yeah.
Everyone's expecting, oh, well, they're definitely not coming here.
Maybe they just were confused and faculty so much that they were, like, their reflexes were completely off.
Well, hopefully when we start getting the interviews rolling in from the event, we might be able to question them about that. I'd certainly like to know if it was intended or... you know, if it was intended, it was all part of some super plan. It's absolute genius. And I think people should be doing more of that kind of thing, so...
I wonder the reaction, because I actually think it was a smoke that he thought he threw. So when they're waiting for like the pop sound from the smoke, and they start to hear like...
Yeah, wait a minute.
Yeah. But that's not a smoke.
So, well, it worked for them. I'm definitely not going to query that. And now they've took the lead again. They've regained their lead. It's 9-8. ESC Gaming should pick up this next one as well, because it looks like we've got an eco coming in for N-Faculty as expected, but as we've already described on this map, there's so many nooks and crannies that you can hide, but it's just easy at the moment. Those SMGs are brutal if you don't have armor, especially. So ESC Gaming now just really starting to turn the screw, and it's going to be interesting to see what happens when the buy rounds occur. I still got a feeling that ESC Gaming are going to edge this one, but N-Faculty certainly look better in this game than they did against NRV, where it was like men against boys, truth be told. So ESC Gaming running away with this eco round. The P90 for Pasha just doing work and picking up some kills. SMN just lurking. I think he's just going to be trying to play for some sort of super exit. What he needs is a decoy grenade.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, for all occasions.
I actually have a question about the decoy grenade.
Yeah?
Does it like change the sounds it's make?
Because depending on the gun
You have. Got, I mean, you can't throw it on the pistol round and it will be an op shot.
No. Because that would be what they call in the business retarded, right? It wouldn't be much of a decoy, would it? Like, oh, look, it's an op in the pistol round.
Yeah.
I wonder what that could be. it does change depending on the gun that you put.
No, we see the first weapon round, right?
Yes, here we go. We're straight into the buy round. We'll have a quick look at the frag charts after this. Certainly, QK Mantis has been N-Faculty's danger man. Asmo with the AWP, and it's interesting because N-Faculty don't really have that designated AWP. They do swap it around. You can see, are ESC Gaming doing the worst strat?
They are doing the worst strat.
They are doing the worst strat in the game. It's the B split. Can they make it work? Kirby's got one kill. Pash is going to answer back. You can see that Asmo is going to use that up very well, and QK Malice is going to get it. So far, it is turning out to be the worst strat. Pash is going to have to do something here. That nade just catches the lip of the door and doesn't do as much damage as you would want. He goes in for the flash, gets a face full of it himself, but does get the kill on QK Malice. It's a 2v2 situation. Bomb ticking away. You can see the bomb is on A bomb site, and Pash is having a look through the window. And he's playing in this advanced position. He is going to get one, so this is a very smart play from him. He's probably heard the other guy coming around, so he's going to call that. You can see Neo, yep, he's received the call. He is in the perfect position to prevent him getting on the defuse. He's just waiting, just playing off the sound. He can hear him coming closer, closer, closer. Just creeping out.
He just
knows he's got to get the defuse.
I think he can make it. I actually think he'll get it.
Ooh. Oh, that was so close.
Well, the bomb wasn't in a great position, but in the end, Neo did just read it right. How close was it?
It was, seriously,
what, 1 second?
Yeah, less than 1 second. Like 1/10 of a second away.
Well, I guess it was all planned. It's all part of the plan. Really easy, Polish fans. We want Polish win.
And they actually won the worst tactics tactic in CS.
Oh, yeah. And they won with the worst tactics. I can't wait to talk about Lemon Dogs, because some of your predictions have been absolutely rotten. So we're gonna get onto that much, much later. But it's still a game underway.
Yeah, in my defense, that was the worst tactic in one.
Okay. I will let you off. But we've got an eco coming in anyway. So N Faculty are probably not going to do a lot, although, again, they have managed to pick up a kill. QK Mantis. I think it was, no, sorry, it was Kirby. Kirby managed to get that kill. And he's got the Kirby image for all you fans of the original game on NES, or SNES if you're a little bit older. Not going to do much. And that's a great little sort of reaction there from Lord to adjust his aim. That's going to make it 12 rounds to 8 now. We were going to have a look at the frag chart, so let's do that. Asmo has crept up to the top. 15 kills, 16 deaths. I'm surprised by that. He seems to have had a quiet game, but evidently not. Cuban at the top, 18 for 12. And it's the mighty Neo down at the bottom. Just want to mention that because, he's got a lot of fans and stuff. So, ESC Gaming are going to face a N Faculty that are on a full bye. You can see Asmo's got that up again, and clearly from the frag charts, he's been doing quite well with it. Smoke's been deployed, and SMN's gone a little bit aggressive there. Caught Pasha out, so he gets a nice early pick, and now N Faculty are going to drop back with that numerical advantage, safe in the knowledge that they can keep these bomb sites reserved. And that's a great. Asmo gets a headshot and still manages to get the AWP kill on Neo. It seemed to be a headshot through maybe the bits of wood or something, because it didn't do full damage, but it definitely made the headshot noise. Don't know if that's another bugging go.
And but there's two guys at B now where ESC is going with the bomb, so... They're actually going down the cellar. The overview tricked me.
Yeah, well, it's called the cellar, although I do know some players like to call it Fritzel. it's a dark dungeon from which no people ever come out of. I personally find calls like that quite tasteless in town. There you go. Lord is going to get the kill. Asmo's going to answer back. So Asmo is having a good game, actually. He's doing quite well. 2v3 situation. The three are being in favor of the German team and Faculty. You can see as well, though, that Cuban is on this bomb site, about to get the bomb down. So, yeah, bomb is planted, and it's now a 2v2 situation. Cuban playing well, but Kirby in a great position. Just gets a headshot over the top of the box, and then some great reaction aim just to pick up Taz. He is going to pick up the defuse. It's going to be 12-9. So, it's becoming a quite a close game. Is there anything ESC need to do to break down this N Faculty defense? More B splits, for example?
Yeah, maybe more B splits. No, I think they should do what they're doing. I mean, they tried a slow round. N Faculty won the aim duels, got the two early picks, so there's basically nothing they can do that round. But it shouldn't make them have any fear for doing their standard round.
Well, N Faculty. Looks like they're going to do what they did last round, actually, and just go a little bit aggressive and do some peaks. Bomb down in spawn for ESC, so they've come back to get it. Having some sort of advanced reconnaissance mission. You can see that Disrupt is about to get a face full of Taz, and he's going to get the kill on him as well. So it's another round that N Faculty have made that first kill, which is vitally important within the context of the game. So we're just waiting to see here, because Neo is in a good position. He could potentially pick up two kills here, but yeah, aim just momentarily eludes him. He goes for the nade. He is facing two of them. Yeah, he is going to get taken down by QK Mantis. Pasha, though, knows that he's low, so he's going to do the follow-up frag. Knows there's one on the right, but insta-headshot from SMN. And make that another kill on the Cuban, and make that a three-man just in the perfect place. And it's 12 rounds to 10. Right, I've got to ask you, right? We did this last time, the game is getting close, and we asked you partway through who was going to win. Do you want to change your prediction? Do you still see ESC Gaming getting this, or are N-Faculty going to nick it from the jaws of death?
I think ESC will win it. Even if N-Faculty wins this round, I think and ESC will have a timeout eco and gather themselves. So I really believe ESC will win anyways.
That's
I think
my feelings too, but I'll tell you what, N-Faculty are looking a very different prospect to the team that got manhandled by Na'Vi. So I'm guessing if anyone wants to beat them in the tournament, probably pick Train. Because they don't seem to have a lot of strats on it. Mirage, they look a completely different team. But Asmo's going aggressive in mid now and going to get that pick. And he's been doing that all game. Well, all half, I should say. So playing incredibly well. Removes Neo, who's probably not having one of his greatest games for ESC.
Yeah, that's one of the reasons why I don't like attacking through that middle. Is that actually so many angles the CT can pick you up from, like the balcony, from that catwalk area, from the connector. It's like it's so hard to cover every area.
Well, they've got a 4v4 now, but certainly a health advantage, I would say, just looking at the way the bars are lined up here. 4 N-Faculty, so a lot on this next kill, and Pasha just turned away at the vital moment. Asmo peaks and gets another kill in mid for himself. Very frustrating when that happens as a player. Especially when it happens online. You do tend to make accusations at that juncture, but Lord tries for the push, and in the end it's Asmo just locking it down at the moment, playing so, so well. And what a great time for him to come into form. 12 rounds to 11 now to ESC Gaming. N-Faculty with a prospect of tying this game up. And I'm just looking at the buy.
They so actually had the money. But yeah. I think they were low with the Cuban with a P250, so they really need to get this round now, I feel.
Yeah, if not, it's going to be an eco, and therefore probably is the lead for N-Faculty. Let's see how they're going to play it. I'll quickly go to the overview just to have a little look. And you can see where the bomb's going. They're certainly heavily leaning towards A. Big Pasha just flexing his muscles down in the basement, down in Fritzl there. Just kind of hanging around. Probably going to mess with their heads at B. You can see Cuban is getting the flashes and smokes going over the top. So it looks like they're committing to this A rush. There's no decoys out. So and then N-Faculty have just got two easy kills there. It was a bit sloppy, not quite coordinated. Taz is going to answer back though. So what's happening in the smoke? UK Mantis just lurking away, but Taz read that situation smartly. And perhaps that nade gave him away. And sometimes the nade in the smoke can give you the reveal. Taz, wow, absolutely sick. Like, saw a pixel and just took his head clean off. Playing so well here, Taz. Already on a three-man. Good 28p. Will he add to his tally? Yes, he will. He's going to get another one before he gets taken down, and then it's Neo just backs him up. And that round just all about Taz
Yeah. Absolutely.
About Taz.
That was such a good individual performance from Taz. He took four frags. They will get down with a 3v5, I think.
Yeah.
And if they would have lost that round, they would have been forced to an eco. So basically, he saved their chances in this game, I would
Yeah, and that's what you need. I mean, when players like him, as we've highlighted him consistently throughout the tournament, when players like him are on form, you need them to make those moments, you know, happen for you. You need them to be absolutely, you know, on point. And again, it's not just one round that he's won for his team there. It's potentially two, potentially three, with just that one individual moment of brilliance to get that four-man. So absolutely incredible play from him. And now, of course, they can afford to buy guns. So we're seeing ESC Gaming spreading out over the map, much like we've seen them do several times, except this time it looks like the bomber. Well, no, he is moving back around, actually, back to the T-spawn area. They've tried to throw in something of a little fake here, and you can see Kirby's actually getting quite advanced. So I think as soon as Kirby gets into that mid area, he's going to call that they're not actually there. And that's going to let them know that chances are they're going to hit up A with some sort of A split. That's indeed the strat that they're going for at the moment. The flash has come in, make that two. QK Mantis in a good position. The flash clears just in time. He gets one kill, somehow two kills. Taz gets two kills as well. It's really been about both of these guys. They're just locked in some sort of personal battle to carry their team. Asmo, for the first time in a while, misses an upshot, but gets it at the second attempt. And again, that was all about, as I perceive it, that little bit of exploration from Kirby. If he doesn't leave B bomb site, he can't make that call.
Absolutely. I mean, even though the C2 weren't there yet when the attack happened, they were like halfway there, which basically, when the terrorists, they weren't even on the site where there were four CTs defending A, and then it's basically over.
And it has forced them into that eco that we kind of foresaw earlier. So ESC Gaming could be about to get tied up at 13-all, and that's definitely the disruptor position. He loves it there on top of that box. It is just perfect for headshots because the box just does all the aiming for you.
Yeah, absolutely. And as I said earlier, we're going to see an timeout eco from ESC because they know they don't have the momentum right now. They have to speak about what to do next round, and they know they're going to lose this round anyway, so they can just spend talking with each other.
And I guess the best teams do that. I think there should be timeouts in tournaments, actually.
I think there are timeouts.
I mean, like literally, like probably through a game.
There were before, I think, at least.
I think 1.6, some of the big tournaments did have them. It was never anything that took off in Source.
Yeah, but you can still use a Glock Eco.
People had to fake PC problems to kind of get timeouts in Source. That was a classic thing. Oh, I've forgotten how to plug my mouse in. I'm an experienced sponsored player. They would do things like that because for technical problems, you would get like half an hour of stoppage time. But anyway, you can see for yourself the frag charts. SMN at the top now of MFAGLE, 25-20. Taz back where he belongs, the king of ESC gaming, 27-20. It's 13-all, and realistically, you cannot tell which way this game's going to go. We finally got ourselves another close game after having a couple of lame ducks, so to speak. Very one-sided affairs.
Just look at Disruptor's position. Oh, he just got it. We were actually pushed towards T-Spawn, hearing every rotation from the team.
Yeah, and finally, you played that brilliantly. SMN as well, with two great kills, a headshot on Pasha, and then quickly flicking onto Neo to pepper him with body shots. Taz, last man standing, 1v3 situation. You can see SMN again, brilliant movement to get up on that box, and Taz didn't expect that at all. N Faculty get a temporary lead. How temporary, we shall see. ESC Gaming, what are they going to do here? I mean, they're not playing for a draw. This isn't an eco.
No, they have to buy. And as you said earlier, N Faculty playing so aggressively in getting that information. Disruptor pushed the house area on A, and he heard all terrorists rotating back from the T-spawn. He just called it, okay, I stay here. You guys can all come here. I know it's going to be an A push.
Well, they haven't bought, so that's definitely something to note. So it looks like the ESC are going to be playing for the draw. SMN's going to get two kills again. He's been really in form as well. It's just been some great individual performances, and then Faculty have really grown into this game. Neo, last man standing, has got an AK. What a time it would be for him to roll back the years and show some of that three-time gold medalist World Cyber Game champion skills that we all know he possesses. He has got two kills so far, so he's on for an ace with a 1v4 component to it. QK Mantis just looking through the tiniest gap. Autodirector fascinated by gaps. It loves it. It's just like, he's not there.
He's going to get the frag.
And then it goes off. Autodirector, what's up, bro? What have you done that for? But in the end, I wasn't going to get the kill anyway. Neo's just kind of, he's getting peppered. He's got so much to do. He's down to 8 HP. QK Mantis has got himself into this advanced position. Asmo comes up in advanced position. It's more like a game on a hide-and-seek server at the moment. I'm expecting Neo to morph into a fridge and just like be hiding in a corner. Shoulder peaks, doesn't fool Asmo. That gets them to match point for N Faculty.
After test round, which made it 13-11, I would never have guessed that N Faculty would pick four rounds in a row. I'm so surprised right now.
Surprised, but are you impressed?
I'm... Well, impressed is not the best word for an Faculty. It's kind of weird that they came from one game to another. They completely changed their level.
I know.
It's actually kind of a... They can play this well, but they can still play as bad as did versus Na'Vi. It's not a sign of a consistent team.
Well, they're not out of the woods yet. Two more rounds to be played. And there's still a chance of a draw. You can see Lord's going to get the first kill, which is going to perhaps set them up. Pasha taken down. Probably should have done better there. Asmo was on the ropes and in close quarters with an AWP. That's going to make it a 4v4 situation. Wicked shot from Taz again. Just loving it at the moment. He's managed to get himself out. Cuban is going to go. He seems to be the designated bomb planter. He does love to get onto that site and just plant behind those boxes. Kirby's going to take down Lord Cuban. He's going to get a kill. And then a bit of a lag coming in. And before you know it, Asmo gets a kill, but in the end, Neo gets a nade for the last one. So 15-14, it's all on this round. Are we about to see a 16-14 game or a 15-15 draw?
ESC want to win this round so bad, because they know if they win this round and then they beat Na'Vi, they will win the group and they won't have to go to the second group
stage. Yeah, and they won't have to go to the second group stage, which of course will save them the pain of having to play those extra games if they don't get this round and they lose. Then yeah, you're right, they can't win the group, I don't think, mathematically.
I think it will be a three-way tie between Enfaculty, EC, and Na'Vi, so a lot of pressure on this round.
Well, and it's certainly not gone well for them to begin with, because it looks like, well, they are already a man down. Pash has been taken down, and Neo and Taz are on half health, so they're going to have to pull something very special out of their Polish playbook if they are to turn this round around. But who knows? I mean, we've seen Enfaculty throw away some ridiculous situations. You can see they're all kind of stacked up in that house area. All it's going to take is one controlled spray. Taz is the point man. Oh. He's going to get one. Perhaps Disruptor shouldn't have pushed and peeked. A little bit, a lack of discipline. That's going to settle Taz's nerves a little bit. You can see QK Mantis, he's just under the ladder. Taz is going to know someone's there. He knows all about this position. He knows where people like to lurk. And QK Mantis is going to get one, make that two. Great, just under his aim. He's going to get a three. He's just single-handedly won this round and won the game for Enfaculty. And in the end, he doesn't get the last kill, but probably he's would. It's GG. It was 16-14 to the Germans, triumphing over the Poles in, and well, I don't think either of us saw that coming.
As you said, it's a very balanced map, and it's really fun to watch as well. If this would have been trained, I think the winning team would have won with like bigger score. So, great map, great match.
Yeah, I think it was a hugely entertaining game. I think there was lots of good points there.